5 to 7, courtesy of Lucky 3 Chisoka. And guess what? We've been talking about Gantak City, the main man himself. Beanie Ganta in the building.
Yo. Open doors. Greetings. Wagwan, everybody. 5 to 7, we're lagging, we're checking. Urban TV.
This is like family, so we know, yeah, like saying welcome home.
Straight, man. Yeah, I'm in the sitting room, I'm home. Wow, yeah.
How's it going? How's everything going for you?
Yeah, bless, we give thanks.
I should say well done on the album.
Thank you, bro.
And that is the reason why we want to focus our interview today.
Yes. Yeah. No Fear.
No
album.
Fear.
Yeah.
Yes.
No Fear album. No Fear. 25 tracks.
Yeah.
Let's first talk about the fact that you called it No Fear.
Yeah.
Why No Fear?
Yeah, the word No Fear defines me and defines my attitude and defines my journey and my success, whatever I've achieved. It is all because of No Fear and God.
Yeah, yeah.
Because if it was never for God, we would never be here. I would be out of the kind of style I'm doing because of frustration and all of them people's stories and all of that. So I had to do it with No Fear. That's why the album is called No Fear.
No Fear.
Yeah.
25 tracks.
Yeah.
Usually, most of the albums have been released by a couple of artists in Uganda. But Zibira Kenya Banga Sinyi, Nyonyi Banga Kumina Musambu, Munana, Kumina Tan. Yeah. But I'm wondering, why did Beanie Ganta, No Fear, why did you decide to make it 25 tracks?
Yeah, I mean, I follow no trend. I just do my own thing. 25 tracks is what I can manage. I even had an idea of releasing 30 tracks.
Come on, Beanie.
Serious thing. Yeah.
Like 30 tracks on one album.
What's wrong with that? If I have the music, what's wrong with it?
You can. It's his album.
No, listen, I'm not following no trend, your bridging. I'm not following any trend. Even if I do an album of 100 songs, that is my strength.
Yeah.
You know, earlier on, when I had an interview, the first interview I had with him, he talked about something that I really want to critically remind you.
Yeah.
You said you literally have over 3 albums already recorded.
Yeah, I told you that. And that time we had like 60 songs, and you can imagine how much time has passed and how many songs do you think
like
I've done after
eight
that.
Months?
So it doesn't, it's not something to show off or anything, but it's just something to be thankful for, because I record songs like 3 songs a week.
Yeah.
You understand? And oh, this is good music. If I keep all these songs, what are they going to do? Do you want to release them when I'm not here? No. Let me make my contribution. Just follow me on my online stores.
Yeah.
Let me release this music. The good thing about this music is that it's not bubblegum music. Yeah. It's music that's with a purpose. Music that maybe says something or drives you to do something. You understand?
Yeah.
But at the end of the day, it is music that is timeless.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's talk about how you spiced up the album. Who's on the album? Because I realized some of the songs that we have heard were not on the album. And some of the collaborations were also not on the album. And others that we didn't expect were on the album. Let's talk about all that. How do you spice it up?
I don't know, man. It's all my team. You know, my thing is just going to studio. Me, I love to sing. That's my thing.
Yeah.
I love to sing and experience real life experiences. So I get to studio and I leave that to management. So Talent Africa and Gantak City handled the selection of the songs and all of that.
Wow,
yeah.
Wow. Oh, by the way, you were there during the launch party for the
listening party.
Listening party, rather.
Well, I actually wasn't there, but I was there by soul. I had my representative, our producer, who was there for me. I mean, I was sick, and there's no way I cannot attend.
How's the listening party? Because we anticipated for that. But Team 5 to 7 was down there. How did that make you feel, releasing this album in a special way?
We give thanks for everything, man. We come from far. So if we see things, good things, and achieving part of the dreams happening to we give thanks to Almighty God, because these are the things that we work for every day.
One thing I know is that this album is already literally available everywhere, Spotify, iTunes. How is it doing online? Kubanga, ekintu ekimu kyetulina okwogerako nti Ugandans in particular, tebagala nnyo ogula albums, especially when it comes to ebintu bya online ebyo, ogenda oteeka mu kadi ate bikibikibikibi. So how is it doing online for you?
No, you who is saying it is, you are the one who is making it seem like that. But we are all not like that. Don't only speak for those people who don't buy.
Yeah,
I'm talking about the majority.
And the music is not only for Uganda. We're doing this music
it's
for the world. You understand? So we have artists who are focusing here. You understand? and we have artists who have the capability to blow out.
Yeah.
So it's not a matter of I want to conquer here only, no. We want to conquer everything. We appreciate our brothers and sisters who are doing the local music and it's doing perfectly well.
Yeah.
Thank you for keeping the culture.
Yeah.
We want to take the culture international, same way. How are we going to take it there? By using a medium of communication that all Lipa people can understand, a big number of people can understand. So if me sing in English or I use patua, it's not like I'm not proud of this. No, I want to send my message to a bigger crowd, you understand?
Yeah.
That's why you see, I feel blessed to see my music is playing in the UK, my music is
the
playing
Caribbean.
In Jamaica, my music is in is playing in Nigeria.
That
is representing Uganda, same speed.
Yeah.
Yeah, we have people who do things and we have people who also do other things.
Specialization
in the music industry.
I want to talk
about like that.
Your recent collaborations, right?
Yeah.
So, wow, it's been a while since you came back here and you've done so much.
Yeah.
How many months now? Three?
I appreciate
four?
You for doing for doing whatever you're doing. Keep going with that.
Is Zanu launching 5-7?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
We appreciate you. 5-7. Keep doing the hard
family,
work.
Family,
yo. So my question is, you've been doing some interesting collaborations.
Mm. Yeah.
And there's one that caught my interest of this beautiful lady from Kenya.
Tanzania.
Tanzania.
Yeah.
And you have this song, it's called Hot Like That.
Yeah.
Tell us about that jam and tell us about the girl.
She's crazy. Yeah?
She's fire, yo.
I like a freaky girl like that.
Yeah. She's freaky, nice. And you know, them kind of people are always real people.
Yeah.
You understand? People
those are the
who,
kind of people you
yeah,
work so
yeah,
yeah.
easily
yeah, those are the people you can really relate with if you're also real. In that sense, so Rosary is a big artist. Is a big artist. Africa should I look out for because she's focused and she's a hustler. You understand? And that's my kind of attitude. I appreciate her music and she appreciates my music. So when we linked up, we had to do something. We linked up at Bank Records. We recorded the song at Bank Records, Ed Kenzo's studio.
Yeah.
And Stain producer, as always.
Oh, big up to Stain, buddy.
Yeah, Stain.
You know, when you hear about Stain, you may think, Wamsaji Amukulu.
So, why we sang about Hot Like That? It's the current situation. We're hot like that.
All right.
You want to disagree?
Do you have a video coming out soon with that?
Yeah, the video is dropping soon.
All right.
Yeah.
Okay, I wonder what she's going to bring out. I feel like I'm gonna be surprised.
But you know, we should say, I know you love all that music, all these collaborations you're doing. Is there any specific collaboration that of the season you feel like, man, this is I love what we did on this one, what we dropped and everything?
You know, I love all the collaborations. Like I love all of them because I've worked with my friends.
Yeah.
And them artists when I work with are positive artists. So before we go to studio doing anything, the first thing we have to focus on is our connection. And I love the people that I've connected with in this music industry because everyone has led me somewhere and maybe I've led them somewhere. So we still give thanks for everything.
So Billy, the year is about to come to an end.
Yeah.
This past year, like I said, this year you've really done it. You've really impressed us.
Mm.
You've done a great job.
Thank you. So much
has been released. What was your favorite concert that you performed this year? Like, you know, you've done many stage performances, but which one was the biggest for you where you felt so much energy and love?
Hey man, this year has been so blessed,
yeah.
and the past years. And I don't know, man, every time I get on stage is a good time for me.
Yeah.
And mostly when I'm doing live.
Yeah.
So all the live performances we've done have
been
my best shows because I don't like CD so much.
Speaking about
I'm
performances,
saying that,
yeah.
My favorite was
Nyege Nyege.
Nyege Nyege. When you performed.
Oh,
and
you see, it was still live.
And I'm even surprised I remember this because. Okay. So the whole thing was when you took everyone switched off their lights and whatnot, and then the phones came up, and you were performing which song? The beautiful
Circle Down. It was Circle Down live, acoustic.
And that was you really sang your heart out there, and people felt that energy.
I mean, music is my love, so
when I'm
singing, I'm pouring out my heart.
All right.
Speaking about performances, I recently heard from from one of your teammates somewhere that Bini Gante is only now doing like performances. We're no longer going to see Bini Gante on a CD anywhere again. How true is that?
We are working towards that. Yeah. We're working towards that because we cannot do it right now because there are no facilities.
Yeah.
Maybe the not all the promoters are able to put up a live show, band show, because it's more costly. But that's what we would love to do. And we are looking forward to getting our own band and then run things our own way.
And recently I also heard that Gantok City, Talent Africa, did some innovation and renovations when it comes to the team that handles Bini Gante. How is the new experience with the new team that you're working with? Because a couple of people, experts, have been added to make sure that your music goes worldwide here and there.
Yeah, it's all a great experience, but it's kind of rocky. You know, like new relations and that. Sometimes you need to learn new things from new people, and then new people need to learn new things from you.
Yeah.
So along the way, some little things happen, but we still move it, you know.
So
right.
Are we expecting any, except from what's called Like That? Are there any more music videos that are coming up this year?
Yes, of course, man. I'm not gonna tell you I'm gonna drop a song after four months or 2 weeks or what. I'm just dropping music because all my online channels are set now.
Yeah.
So we are free to release music any day. You just need to keep up with us.
Can you imagine three songs every after? Every week you record like over three songs.
Yeah.
Oh man.
Yeah. That is. What can I say? So this man loves the studio.
It's more like we doing the show every day, Monday to Friday. So they're also in studio, busy recording all your music. Man.
Yeah, like music is my job. Just the same way you wake up every day, you have to report here.
Yeah.
It's the same way.
So since you came here, are you still single?
No, I'm not single. I've never been single.
Okay.
All right.
All right, what are we going to do now? We're still here with Bini Gante. We're going to take a little break and with some music from DJ Sister. When we come back, of course, we play our game, Draw False.
We're going to play our games.
Yeah, we have two games, by the way. So,
yes.
Are you ready for that?